This is Gail at Lady Fingers Sewing Center in beautiful Ole, Pennsylvania. We got in this fantastic shipment from Andover Fabrics. This is a Batik collection by Edyta Sitar, and it's called A Splash of Color. This is a brand new collection of Batik fabrics. They are splendid and wonderful, and of course come in a wonderful range of colors, as only Edyta knows how to do. This is pattern 8692 in the color P, which stands for purple, although it has other colors in it. There's another rainbowy one. This is gorgeous. I think this will last for about 5 minutes. And these are only 10 yard cuts. So if you want them, you need to come and get them. This one is color, I think it's Y. All right. All of these will be posted on the Lady Fingers website for you to purchase. And of course they are available now in the shop. This is color O. Absolutely wonderful. For those of you who applique, these ombre striated colors in Batik are wonderful because you have a lot of different colors all in one cut of fabric. Here's a great green. It has bits of light and dark in it. So again, if you're doing appliques or patchwork, you're going to get a wonderful variety of shades of green in one piece of fabric. Here's a cute little dotty one. This is little speckles. And this one, well, is $85.98 in color Y. Okay, here's a pretty hexagonal design. The chop is really cool. Chop is the stamp that people who print batiks use to create the designs on the cloth. And this is color R. We have a beautiful bluey, tealy bluey, cadetti bluey, hard to say. Nice leafy print. And I can see Edyta using these in a lot of her designs. Another great mix of blue and green. This is splendid. This is color X. I guess they didn't know what to call it. This is just terrific. We have a great background color, and we're calling this N, and these are little branches, just very delicate and dainty. Makes a great background fabric. The same design in a kind of a celery color with a beautiful blue chop on it. Really nice. More hexagons. Ooh, I like this. So this is really cool, very modern. So the hexagons are a very light aqua color, and it's a kind of an umber, dark brown, charcoal-y background. Okay, here's box number 2 of Edyta Sitar's collection of Splash of Color for 2021. This is fabulous. This is typical Edyta when it comes to batiks. Again, she doesn't name the patterns, or Andover doesn't name the patterns. But this is an Oliver leafy with some flowers design on it, and it is considered color N. Here's another rainbowy one. I know Edyta uses this a lot when she does her silhouettes, and of course that means that Lady Fingers will do the same. And this is color W. And of course we all know that Edyta is all about blue these days, and this is color W. Here's a pretty green speckle, color G. Really nice. The little dots are blue, so it gives a pretty effect. If you're doing a color story that ranges from blue to green, this would be considered a bridge. This is a nice neutral brown. It's almost most like a light espresso color, and this color is considered K. This is another design. This is new out of the box. This is kind of like a spread out spray of leaves and stems and little berries. And this is color O. Note I bought the entire collection, so you should too. Because it's shop hop time, I won't get to getting pre-cuts made right away, but if you are interested, please just let us know by email or call the shop at 610-689-0068, and we'll do our best to accommodate you. This is a really nice gold color, and it is called color Y. Here's a really pretty, it's really hard to do light red, but it's kind of a light red. And it is color R. This is a great color. Another one of that spread out viney leafy thing. This is great because it's an olive green, and then it has really pretty plum and tealy blue chops on it. Really, really nice. Color G. Another fabulous background. This one is a ecru with the nice branches on. It's a very subtle, nice texture for your backgrounds. And this is color L. And who doesn't love a good berry? So this is a nice purpley raspberry color, color P. Color by Edyta Sitar, box number 3. And this is a nice blender. So this is a tealy blue. It has little hints of green in it. Super duper for stems and leaves and things like that. So this is color T. And these are kind of considered solid batiks. So they work well with everything. Non-directional, easy to use. And this is color B. Here's another streaky one. This is nice because it has little hints of teal, and then it goes into a nice royal blue. So this is a good, what we call a bridge fabric. So if you're building your color story in your quilt from blue to teal to green, this is a good bridge. And this is color B, as in boy. It's in blue. Another one in green. I like this a lot. This one's a real pretty medium green, medium light green. You can really see the changes in the color with the little veins. See that? That works really well with all kinds of projects. And this is color G. I like this too. This is a really pretty brown color. This is a soft brown. Has a lot of highs and lows in it. So if you're doing bark or you're just doing brown leaves, I can see this as a beautiful oak leaf, which are outside right now. This is color N. And here we're back to that pretty chop with the leaves and flowers on it in a nice lighter red with bits of green and gold. And this would be color P, even though it's not purple. And it's not quite pink, but anyway, it's P. All right. Another tone on tone, nice rich blue, color W. And this one, I know it'll be hard to see on your screen, but this is called K. It is a charcoal, but it has a greenish cast to it. So it's a wonderful background fabric if you're looking for a dark background, or it would make a great stem or a small leaf. Lovely sapphire blue, tone on tone, color B. And here's another speckly guy. This is a nice tealy color with dark blue dots on it, and it is color T. And last one in the box is just Screaming Autumn. This one is called Screaming, oh no, it's not called Screaming Autumn. It is actually a color P for some reason, but it's got nice yellow greens, and then the top is purple, but it changed color in the batiking process to muddy it up. So it's kind of reddish, kind of purplish, kind of pinkish, but from far away it just looks brown. So here, there you go. And on to, I think, the last box. Hey, here's the last box from Splash of Color by Edyta Sitar. Just arrived last night. We got the full collection in 10-yard cuts, so hurry in to get your share. This is a nice little vein, like a little sprig, and it's done in a multitude of colors, and this one is color T. Next one is also spriggy. I'll call this spriggy. How's that? And this will be color R, even though it's more orangey than red. Okay. We have more of the little dots. These little sprinkles are really good for lots of different things because they don't feel directional and they're small. It's a small scale, so it's easy to use. And this is color B as in blue. There's that spriggy one again. This is very soft, nice soft tealy blue. And I'm sure it is color B. Okay. Here's another, if you need a slightly darker background, very often in today's quilts, we use more than one background color to add just another element to our quilts. And this would be a step darker than the other backgrounds that I've shown you thus far. This is color L. Here's that big spread out sprig in a very beautiful pumpkin color. And this is color Y. Here's another streaky one. Again, great for a background. Just let it ride. Don't worry so much about direction. This adds a really nice texture to things, and it has a lot of different tones in it. Some bone, a little bit of cream, and some gray, which is super nice. And it is color L. Just a few more to go. This is called color G. And it is mostly green. It has a little bit of blue, a little bit of umber in it too. So it's a nice darker leaf or whatever element if you're doing patchwork. And here's that really cool hexagon I like so much. And this one is N, it's brown. And then the lighter part is just sort of a bit of a cream, maybe touches of blue and a bit of green in it as well. And this is color N. Almost done. We have a beautiful red. Edyta does a great job with her red tones are sort of pinkish usually. And this one, it does not disappoint. It is the nice spriggy with the flowers and the leaves on it and color R. Last but not least, the hexagon in a brown color. They're calling it color G, which normally means green, but it's olivey. And brownish, goldish, again, kind of an autumn-y look to it. Really nice. So thank you for watching. I hope you come into Ladyfingers very soon. Check us out online at ladyfingersewing.com. And please sign up and subscribe to our YouTube channel. I think we have probably about 80 videos up there at this point. And so check that out. And certainly come into the shop at Ladyfingers Sewing. Thanks for watching.